There's uncertainty facing the state's largest school system as students prepare to head back to class.
Funding for teacher assistance is still in limbo, and today we learn the Wake County school system is down 100 teachers to start the year. WNCN's Maggie Newland is live outside Millbrook High School in Raleigh to explain. Good evening, Maggie.
Sharon, school hasn't started yet, but kids here are already in the school spirit. They're getting ready for a football game a little bit later tonight. On Monday, though, the focus turns to academics as kids here and across the county head back to their first day of class.
It's back to the books for traditional school students in Wake County, and kids aren't the only ones who might be dealing with back-to-school jitters.
Very nervous.
Nearly 700 teachers are new to the Wake County public school system. More than half of those are first-year teachers, including Vasti Rodriguez, who will teach special education classes at Fuquay Varina Middle School.
It's a brand new experience, hoping to be ready, organized, set, just have a lot of excitement for the students.
But there are students who will start the school year without a permanent teacher. The county has about 100 teacher vacancies.
We start with substitutes, or our principals are really resilient at figuring out the best way to optimize staffing to make sure that every student has a qualified teacher in their room. So be it a substitute or someone that is doing a variety of roles in the schools.
While the number of vacancies is higher than last year, the district says 99% of its positions are filled and the recruiting and hiring process is ongoing.
That as candidates apply online, we are able to find them a quality position and they go through the process and then they're able to start.
2,200 teachers' assistants will start school Monday, but without a state budget, funding for those positions is still uncertain.
If we have to come up with a plan B, we certainly will. We don't have that yet because we're confident that the folks at the legislature will recognize and see the value that those TAs add to our classroom.
For now, though, the focus is on the kids.
And the district says it is up to full staff on bus drivers. Of course, those buses will hit the road Monday morning. We're live at Millbrook High School. Maggie Newland, WNCN News.
All right, Maggie, thank you. And looking ahead to next school.